For this episode of the Dump and Chain Show, we are very happy to welcome on our dear friend from BR Open Ice, one of the better personalities in the NHL, and I guess we can call her the style queen. I don't know if you have a title with that yet, but let's welcome Sara Civian. Sara, what's going on?
Hey, what's up? It's so funny that like the style queen thing has happened because I'm not the most stylish person. I just wanted to like show players' personalities, but I'm like, hey, I'll take it.
Yeah, and also I should say we wouldn't be doing St. Patrick's Day justice if we didn't crack open a drink. So
Johnny said he was going to get a Guinness, though.
No, yes. Guinness for Johnny. Went to the local deli and there was no Guinness, so I'm going with a Stella.
Wow, he's actually also drinking it. I'm impressed.
Stella coffee and water.
The big
The St. Patty's Day hat trick. But yeah, let's just hop right into it. Sara, this year you're with BR Open Ice. We're colleagues. We work together. It's been a lot of fun doing that. But can you just talk about all the different storylines that you cover in the NHL? Obviously, you're a Boston Bruins homer, so I think you're going to go that way. But what's been your favorite story so far this year, this season?
Well, it has been incredible with the Bruins. It's like every time you think they're going to slow down or something, they just speed back up. They got their 10th regulation loss on March 12th. Like, that is absolute insanity in a league that, especially in the East, right? Like, it's been such an insane race to the playoffs. So obviously that, and they weren't supposed to be good. So who doesn't love that? Mm-hmm. I love that. Like, Bergeron coming back, all the right moves being made. I love the story with Jim Montgomery, right? Second chance, and then Jake DeBrusque as well after he requested a trade. It's like you got all that. And I see your Devil's hat on. I really like the Devil's storyline too, and the fact that they went for Meyer. Like, we've been waiting on them to make a big move. We thought maybe it would be goaltending over the summer, and it wasn't, although the goaltender they did pick up is doing really well. So kind of goes to show to be patient with teams a little bit. I really like the Devil's storyline. Sorry, Johnny.
That's okay. I like it too.
To build off that too, I think like everyone expected Meyer to get traded to the Devils for what seemed like 2 months. It seemed just like the obvious addition for that team. They needed a forward with a little size and a bunch of skill on the wing. And so to actually see them make that move, I think was great. And they also didn't give up too much to get that kind of player, which I think was awesome. And they, no one expected them to do this well this season. They were like a borderline fringe playoff team. I know Dom's rankings always has the Devils model like higher than most people, than what actually happens.
The so it's Dougie good to Hamilton actually see
it play out for once.
Exactly. Every team with Dougie Hamilton on it is like so good in his model.
I mean, you covered him when he was with the Canes, I'm sure. He's a great person. He's just a little, he likes to do his own thing, which is fine, but he's an incredible hockey player.
I think he sucks. I'm just kidding.
I did want to ask too about, because obviously you used to cover the Hurricanes. I want to get your thoughts on the Svechnikov injury and how that might impact them. Obviously, they're only 1 point clear of the Devils with 2 games in hand in the Metro. And if they had to play with the Bruins in the Eastern Conference Final, how you think that loss might impact their play?
Yeah, it just absolutely sucks because Svechnikov is one of the hardest working, most genuine, nice guys. He grew up with nothing, him and his brother, and now they're both in the NHL, or at least if Evgeny is close to the NHL, he like comes up and down. But Svech will be out there for hours working on his game, and he is a really dynamic player. He has like sides to him, right? Like, he's not going to always score 20 goals. I don't know. He's going to score 20 goals, but maybe not always 30. But I think people expect him to be a goal scorer when he's really like always up there with hits, always up there with passing. And he's so versatile that it's so brutal when you lose a player like that. And I know Mike Rousseau reported that he was apologizing to the GM Dom Waddell over and over. He's like, I'm so sorry, Don. It just like literally makes me want to cry because he's such so a sad sweetheart. But it sucks, and the Canes should have done more at the trade deadline.
They're not scary.
It was an arms race in the Metro, and you saw every team, like in the East even, like the Atlantic, every team kind of added a couple really big pieces, and then the Canes just kind of sat, and they do what they do, right? They added Gostisbehere, they added Puljujärvi, so they're good depth parts, but they didn't really add that superstar, and now with the Svechnikov injury, that really kind of impacts their depth.
Yeah, and they've never really had that superstar. I mean, they have Aho, Svechnikov, Natchez, but it's like all these really good players, and there hasn't been every time, every season during the playoffs, the scoring dries up, and it's like you can work your ass off and you can be this really sound defensive team and have all these good players, but if you don't have that ace on the power play during the playoffs, you're gonna be having a tough time.
Let's steer away from the Hurricanes because I don't give a crap about them, and I'm sure most people listening don't. Just kidding, Carolina, you're really good. And don't beat the Rangers because that'd be really exciting.
One step of Stella in him, and he's
just a liquid courage getting to me a little bit.
But this is influencer Johnny now.
Oh, here we go. Okay, I thought we were gonna avoid that. I'm wearing the Faraday shirt, and I'm gonna ask Sara a style question. Well, I'm actually not gonna ask you a style question. We're gonna do a rapid fire, somewhat style scenario. There's 13 games tomorrow on Saturday in the NHL. I'm going to tell you the matchups. I want the first player that comes to your mind in between those two teams of who has the best style, if that's okay. It's going to be a lot because 13 is a lot.
I can handle it.
All right. You ready to start it off?
Yeah.
Colorado, Detroit.
Mo Sider.
Okay. That's a good one. Actually, I would have like totally not even leaned that direction, but Boston, Minnesota.
Pastrnak.
Obviously.
Mm-hmm. Lock. Winnipeg, Nashville.
Adam Lowry.
Not Yossi?
Off the grid.
No. Okay. Edmonton,
Check
Seattle.
Check out Lowry's style. Okay, what was this?
Wait, what did you say? What was
Check
that?
Check out Lowry's style. He looks like a really cool TA.
I actually know nothing about him, so I will look it up after. Edmonton and Seattle.
Ooh. Wenberg?
Oh.
He has a good style. Yeah, Vince Dunn has a good style, too.
He loves the like all white creamy suits. I'm into that.
Mm-hmm. McDavid has no style.
Absolutely not. He's zero drip.
Yeah. Your Carolina or your former Carolina Hurricanes and the Philadelphia Flyers.
Ooh.
Uh-oh, we stumped her.
Yep.
No.
There's too many. Too many to choose from.
Anderson, maybe, but he's always looking like Harry Potter. He looks like he stepped out of England, but I'm not hating on it. But Natchez is pretty good.
Mm-hmm. I like that one, too. Let's go Devils, Panthers.
Ooh, Anthony Duclair.
Ooh.
He's dripped out.
Style King.
Yeah.
Canadians, Lightning.
Oh, the Lightning have so many good ones. Oh, maybe Victor Hedman, maybe not. Oh, it's
all
tough.
The Swedes.
The Swedish King.
Yeah, the Swedes always have good style. Mm-hmm. This one's obvious. Leafs, Ottawa.
Huh.
Oh, Willie Styles.
Yeah, I mean, he's the coolest. He's the swaggiest guy, in my opinion.
I will say Austin Matthews doesn't have good like pregame looks, but obviously he's in all these magazines and has really good streetwear. So I like to see streetwear from him.
I think Willie is the coolest guy ever.
I agree.
Penguins, Rangers.
Oh, Kendrick Miller.
Yeah, I knew you were going to say that.
Done.
Vancouver and L.A.
Quinton Byfield when he's in the lineup, but I don't know if that counts. I guess Elias Pettersson.
Mm-hmm. We got to see Quinn Hughes step up his style a little bit.
I know, but the Canucks don't really show us much, and sometimes it's in black and white, so I'm not going to fault them too much on it. But
Dallas and Calgary. We got three left. There's a lot of games.
Nikita Zadorov, he called me out once. He was like,
really?
a good eye for fashion.
No
like,
way.
All you do is wear double-breasted suits and think you own the league. I think he's hilarious, though. He had a great interview with Spittin' Chicklets, and I was like, I think that guy's hilarious.
I respect that.
Yeah, I love that. Chicago, Arizona.
Oh, Arizona has been awesome because they don't have the dress code anymore.
Oh,
God. But they sold like everybody that actually had good style. So that's tough. It was Arizona and who?
And Chicago.
Okay.
Chicago has no one you'd even recognize.
I can't even name like seven players in the Blackhawks right now.
Well, Max Domi. Oh, is Max Domi even on the team anymore?
Dallas. He's on Stars.
Both of these teams like traded everyone.
Yeah.
Clayton Keller? How's Keller's style?
I was going to say, I guess Clayton Keller with the streetwear.
And then the last one, Islanders and Sharks, Erik Karlsson. Gotta be.
Yeah, Erik Karlsson done. Yeah. But the Islanders, of course, under Lou, post zero pictures of themselves. Everyone's always yelling at me, of course, Islanders fans. They're like, why aren't our players there? I'm like, show me a picture of them.
Yeah. They have no social media presence.
Yeah.
Okay, that wraps up the Saturday slate. Yeah, that was fun. Between Keith and I, better style.
Oh, I'm not familiar with Keith's game, but you
know, after this, I'll send you some of my style pictures and then you can rank me and Johnny.
Sounds good.
There's one thing I did want to ask you, obviously, with the game is kind of, we all love hockey, but there's things we want to change within the game. So if we could put on our commissioner hat, our Gary Bettman hat, what is the one thing off the top of your head that you would change immediately? Like there's no question about it. This is the first thing that really bothers you with the NHL. And then we can snap it to Johnny and myself too, because we obviously have some ideas too.
Salary cap. I don't want there to, I understand why it exists, but we're just single-handedly keeping Arizona afloat for no effing reason. I'm sorry, Arizona fans that may be watching this, but it's not about you. It's just a disaster of what's happened. And just imagine, I don't know if we want super teams, but the NBA is so fun and so popular for a reason. And I do worry that these players should be making way more money off of what they're doing, right? So I think either like significantly increasing the salary cap or getting rid of it, but I don't think they'll ever get rid of it.
Well, if you look too, obviously over the last 20 years, the increase from all the sports top players, Jaromir Jagr was making $10 million in 2001. McDavid's only making $12.5 million. But you have about the same $10 million in football, and now the quarterbacks are making $50 million. The NBA superstars are making $50 million. NHL players are so underpaid for their star players, so I love
that. It's literally like a labor issue, and it prevents true stars from coming out of the NHL because then they don't have these like endorsed, whatever. It's just like they should be making more money.
My favorite thing is my boy Fitz, who works for BetMGM. Whenever like a big NHL player signs, he always says like, "Oh my God, McDavid's making Alex Crusoe money, like a sixth man in the NBA."
Literally.
Like, yeah, you know, it's so classic every time. It cracks me up when he does that. But
what do you guys think?
Keith, you want to kick that one off?
Yeah, I think it's the NHL Network with their scheduling because they play on the fly on repeat for 16 hours. There's no live programming until 4 p.m. Me and Johnny have been advocating for a great morning NHL show that would be live, get players' perspectives, hosted by someone like Jackie Redmond, who's an absolute superstar. Mm-hmm. I think having a Good Morning Football style show and just more live programming, getting more people involved and not having it behind such a hard paywall to find. It's not streamable on the NHL app, which it is in other sports. And the World Junior Championships is buried on the NHL Network instead of on like an ESPN Plus, which is like the greatest tournament by far every year. And so not as many people get to see it. And you get to see all the true stars who are going to be absolute legends in this league. So I think just the NHL Network programming is pretty poor.
I mean, I definitely agree with that. And Sara, I know we've kind of got back and forth on Twitter in that regard. But for me, I think, you know, when the players speak out about the playoffs and whatnot, too, like, you know, I think who was it? Crosby that said he wanted the 1-8 again. And then Bettman comes out with a statement saying like, "Nah, we're keeping it the way it is." Stuff like that. Just like little things, you know, that are super fixable that like will change the game for the better that like aren't that big of a deal. Mm-hmm. You know, I think the thought process was there with the divisional matchups and the playoffs and stuff. But I think it would be cool to see that 1-8 again. And then for me, just the changes, I think like, you know, I like to see the point system change a little bit. You know, I know the way college works, like you get 3 points for regulation win.
I love 3-2-1-0.
Yeah, the 3-2-1 to me is just the way to go. I think teams should be a little more rewarded for winning regulation. And the overtime loss still should count for something. But, you know, that regulation win should mean a lot more. I mean, in something like us, you know, in the betting space, you know, the price is way better for regulation win. So why not, you know, in regards to the point system? But I actually want to ask another question, too. We'll probably wrap it up with a fun one. Do you have any more, Keith, before we end up?
No, I was just going to say, too, I know your co-host Shayna always talks about the schedule, how it's always just not staggered. Mm-hmm. And I think just staggering it so you can have like you can have constant flow of NHL games from 7 to 10:30 as opposed to 7 games that start at 7 and then they're all at intermission and you just have to sit there for 15 minutes with no idea what to do. And there's no red zone channel, right? There's like there needs to be a goal zone or something.
Oh, there should be. OK,
I tweeted that like 3 years ago. That was like that was like my best idea ever, I think.
It's a great idea, but that's one of those things where I feel like in theory we're all rooting for that, but there's probably a reason why it hasn't happened because it's so obvious, or maybe there isn't, but maybe Shayna should do a story diving into why. I'll pitch that to her.
Yeah, perfect. Definitely. And my final question to wrap it up, there's a lot of star players right now that we haven't seen win the Stanley Cup yet. If you can pick 5 NHL players that haven't won that you'd want to party with most at a Stanley Cup party, who are those 5? Like Pasta to me is honestly like probably number one. Pasta seems like a beauty.
I completely forgot. I mean, I'm from Boston. I'm like, 2011. I forget how young he is.
Yeah.
So yeah. Young. Pasta is a great time. He is fun. David Pastrnak. Who else? Probably Dylan Larkin because I like his competitive nature and I feel like he'd go crazy when he finally wins the cup.
I love that video of him too when he knocks over the guy's beer behind the net in warm up and like has the trainer go give him $20 to buy him a new one. That was awesome.
Oh, I can't handle it. Oh, sorry. Oh no. Oh no. I feel terrible.
Did you knock their beer over?
Yeah, sorry. Hey, where'd Zuby go? Zuby, you got your wallet on you?
Yeah.
You got $20?
I think so. What do you I got 20 bucks in my dry cell. I knocked over the guy's beer.
You got what?
I knocked over the guy's beer.
Oh.
I feel bad. Right behind the net. See him? In the gray, or in the Red Wing sweatshirt. First row. Yeah.
That is a great one.
He mm-hmm. is a great guy. And who else? Okay, let me think who's in this league right now.
Artemi Panarin's got to be a good one, too. Come on.
The bread man. Yeah. I'm sure he knocks back the vodkas.
I was going to say anyone on the Leafs because they haven't won in like 50,000 years.
Mitch Marner, because I want him to have the best time of his life. This poor kid gets his dad, his agent, the Leafs, the fans, his car gets broken into. Let's get him a cup.
He's had a rough go.
Yeah, seriously. And he has a smile on his face every day. And one more person. Oh my God, this is actually a hard question. I'm thinking on the West Coast now. Who's somebody that hasn't won?
Maybe Eichel?
I was going to say, you could say Zegras too. Like, I don't know.
No.
That's
I don't
obvious.
Trust him.
Yeah, it's obvious. You want a mature Stanley Cup party.
Yeah, yeah. I'm a kid.
Eric Carlson,
you want to tip rosé out of the cup.
Yes. Yes, exactly. I would say, I'm thinking of everybody on the Canes, but who's like a fun partier? Who do you guys, who's one
West,
more?
I'm trying to think West Coast.
I would love Jack Hughes just because he lives right by me and he would be incredible to run around Hoboken in New York City with.
Well, I once asked Jack Hughes what his favorite Taylor Swift song was, and he said, I don't have one, but every time I walk into a bar, it seems like they're playing Taylor Swift dubstep. So I'm like, what bars are you going to? Let's party.
Welcome
together.
To Hoboken, right. New Jersey, baby.
All right. Me and Jack Hughes partying in Hoboken. Oh, Dougie Hamilton. Dougie went in 2011.
No,
I don't think so.
I think Sagan and Ben would be. Oh, no, Sagan won with Boston.
Yeah. So that doesn't count. I was there for that. I'll tell you Jamie that. Ben, that guy is fun.
Yeah. Ovechkin, I was in DC in 2018 when Ovechkin won it. And it was just absolute scenes watching them run through the fountains, going to Don Tito's in Arlington, just having people go crazy. It was awesome.
I can't think of one West Coast player.
I know. Like, who?
I said Eichel.
Carlson. You said Carlson. That's a good
one. I said Carlson and Eichel.
On the West Coast now. I don't care. I don't like BU. Sorry.
I was looking at Minnesota and I was gonna say Fleury, but like Fleury's won like three. So
You know what? Jeff Skinner, he has been in the league for 13 years.
He's on the Sabres,
and has not
though.
Made the playoffs once.
Really?
He hasn't made the playoffs once.
That's crazy.
Holy
shit. That's crazy.
Yeah. I didn't know that.
A good attitude.
Yeah.
Well, I would love the Sabres to make a run this year.
Skinner just loves his long summers. But Sarah, we want to thank you so much for doing this. You know, you're the best and keep up the good shit because you make the game fun.
Of course.
You want to plug anything?
Probably this back end. No, just go to my Twitter, click my link tree. All my stuff's there.
Link tree. Love that. All right. Thank you, Sarah.
Thanks so much. See ya.
Thank you. See ya.
We really want to thank our friend Sarah Civian for coming on the show. Always fun talking hockey, talking style, and just talking fun with her. You know, great person to follow. One of the funnier personalities in hockey, like I said before, but overall super fun time. So thanks to Sarah once again. Keith, any final thoughts before we wrap it up?
I really enjoyed that conversation. I think Sarah has got a great hold on the league and kind of what are some things that the league does well and what are some things the league can improve on. As big hockey fans, we all just want to see it get better. So I think Sarah was great, and I enjoyed her style rankings too. Those are fun articles and pictures to see on social media, so she does great with that.
Yeah, we got a fun weekend of hockey ahead. Like we said, 13 different games on Saturday, full Saturday slate, March Madness. I mean, what a sports weekend. The weather's nice outside. So we hope everyone enjoyed listening to this, and we hope you all enjoy your weekend, and we hope you all win some money. But to that, cheers. Happy St. Patrick's Day.
Cheers,
we'll talk
everyone.
To you guys on Tuesday.